Good morning everyone. Children, in the previous module we have discussed exercise 12.1. So in this module I'm going to explain you exercise 12.2, not all sums, because question 1, 2, 3 and 5, 9, they are not in your syllabus now as per the latest deletion done by CBSC. So area of quadrilateral using Heron formula. How to find area of quadrilateral using Heron formula? This topic is deleted now. So we will do question number 4 of exercise 12.2 now. Question number 1, 2, 3 are deleted now. So see question number 4. A triangle and a parallelogram have the same base and same area. If the sides of triangle are 26 cm, 28 cm and 30 cm and the parallelogram stands on the base 28 cm, find the height of parallelogram. So we have to find the height of parallelogram. Now you can see here the solution. This is the figure. A triangle and parallelogram have the same base and it is given base of parallelogram is 28. So triangle also have the base 28 and these are the other two sides of triangle. It is also given, see, sides of triangle is equal to 28 cm, 26 and 30 cm. Base of triangle and base of parallelogram is same, 28 cm. It is also given area of triangle and area of parallelogram is same. So first of all we have to find area of triangle, then we can easily find out area of parallelogram because both are equal. So first, to find area of triangle, take the first side as A, second side of triangle as B and third side as C and find out semi-perimeter. If you remember, in the previous module I told you about Heron's formula, and in Heron's formula we need S. S is semi-perimeter, sum of all sides divided by 2. So we'll get the semi-perimeter as 42 cm. So using Heron's formula, area of triangle, we all know area of triangle is under root S, S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. Then put the values of S, A, B and C, we'll get 42, 42 minus 26, 42 minus 30, 42 minus 28. So we'll be getting 42 into 16 into 12 into 14. So after making factors of 42, 7 into 6, 16, 4 into 4, 12, 2 into 6, 14, 2 into 7. So after making the pairs, and we'll find out the square root. So after taking out square root, we will get 7 into 6 into 2 into 4, that is equal to 336 centimeter square. So this 336 centimeter square is the area of triangle. Now you know that area of triangle and area of parallelogram is given equal in the sum. So area of parallelogram is also 336 centimeter square. So base is 28 centimeter. Base of parallelogram is given and we have to find out how height. It is, we know that area of parallelogram is equal to base into height. So put the value of area 336, base 28. So height will be 12 centimeter. So this is how we can do fifth sum to find the height of parallelogram. First we need area of parallelogram. Base is given, then we can put the values in the formula and we can find out height. Now come to question number 6. Question number 5 is also deleted as it is based on rhombus, and for rhombus diagonal is given, we have to divide the quadrilateral. Rhombus is a quadrilateral and we have to divide that quadrilateral into two triangles. So this portion is deleted. Come to question number 6. An umbrella is made by stitching 10 triangular pieces of cloth of two different colors, each piece measuring 20 cm, 50 cm and 50 cm. How much cloth of each color is required for the umbrella? Now you can see the figure. This is the figure of umbrella. So we can see five parts, five triangular parts in front and five triangular parts at the back. So total it has 10 triangular pieces and you can see this piece is red. If this piece is, for example, of red color, this will be of green color. This will be of red. This will be of green. This will be of red. So in total, we'll get 5 red color pieces and 5 green color pieces. We have to find area of, we have to find how much cloth of each color is required for the umbrella. Now to solve it, see, again we are given, let us take any one triangular piece and dimensions of this triangle is given. So first of all, we'll find the area of one triangle. Total pieces are 10 and triangular pieces of each color is 5 each. So first of all, and as you can see, area for each color will be same. So first of all, we'll find area of one triangular piece. So A is 50, B is 50, C is 20. S will be sum of all sides divided by 2, 60 centimeter. And then using Heron's formula, area of triangle is S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. So after putting the values of S, A, B, C, we'll get 60 into 10 into 10 into 40. And making factors of these numbers, we'll get 2 pairs of 10. 1 pair of 2 and 2 into 3, that is root 6. So we'll get 200 root 6 centimeter square. After taking out square root, we'll get area of one triangular piece as 200 root 6 centimeter square. Now you can see, area of one triangular piece 200 root 6 centimeter square. So area of 5 triangular pieces will be 5 into 200 root 6 centimeter square. So it will become 1000 root 6 centimeter square. This is area of one color, suppose red 5 triangular pieces, area will be 1000 root 6. Similarly, the area of green 5 triangular pieces will also be 1000 root 6 centimeter square. So hence, 1000 root 6 centimeter square cloth of each color is required for the umbrella. So this was question number 6. I hope you have understood this question. Now come to question number 7. A kite is in the shape of square with the diagonal 32 centimeter and an isosceles triangle of base 8 cm and side 6 cm each is to be made of 3 different shades as shown in the figure. How much paper of each shade has been used in it? Now you can see this figure. This kite is in the shape of square with a triangular end. Now it is given that diagonal of square is 32 cm. And we know diagonals of square are equal. It means both the diagonals are of 32 centimeter. And in this triangle, we are given base 8 centimeter. This is an isosceles triangle. Base is 8 and these two equal sides are 6 centimeter each. So we have to find, we have 3 parts. First triangle, second triangle and third triangle. So we have to find how much paper of each shade in each part has been used. So to solve it, you can see the solution. This is the figure. So you can see this is the diagonal 32 and this diagonal is also 32. Since I have named it A, B, C, D and E, F. So first of all, you can see in this square, A, B, C, D, diagonals of square are equal and they bisect at 90. So it means AO is equal to OC. will be 16 centimeter square. So AO is equal to OC will be 16 centimeter and this diagonal BD is 32 centimeter. Now if I take triangle ABD, so in triangle ABD, AO is the height and BD is the base. So I can find out area of triangle ABD using this formula, half into base into height. So after putting the values, I'll get area of triangle ABD, area of triangle ABD as 256 centimeter square. Similarly, you can see in triangle BCD, again base is 32 and this height is 16, because if this is 16, this will also be 16. So BCD again, half base into height, we'll get the same area. So first part area is, we have find second part area we have find. Now we have to see the third part. In this third part, this is an isosceles triangle with these two equal sides 6 cm and third side is 8 cm. Now we have to use Heron's formula to find its area. To find the area of triangle CEF, so you can see this triangle name is CEF. Again, I have to use Heron's formula. So first of all, A is 6, B is 6, C is 8, S is 6 + 6 + 8/2. So semi-perimeter is 10. So area of triangle CEF using Heron's formula, square root S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. After putting the values of S, A, B, C, I'll get factors 10 into 4 into 4 into 2. So 4 into 4, 10 will be written as 2 into 5 and 1, 2. So we'll get one pair of 4, one pair of 2. So area of triangle CEF will become (8√5 cm². So this is the area of this third part. Now you can see area of paper used for first part is first triangle 256 cm², second triangle 256 cm², and third triangle 8√5 cm². So I hope this question is clear to all of you. Now come to question number 8. A floral design on a floor is made up of 16 tiles which are triangular, the sides of triangle being 9 cm, 28 cm and 35 cm. Find the cost of polishing the tiles at the rate of 50 paisa per cm². So this is the figure. It has total 16 tiles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So this is a floral design, a design on the floor which is in the shape of 16 tiles, and this design is to be polished. So we have to find the cost of polishing the tiles, and rate is given, and we are also given the dimension of one triangular tile. So 9, 28 and 35, these are the three sides of triangle. So you can see the figure. This is one triangular tile and dimensions are given. So total tiles are 16. First of all, we'll find area of one tile. So A is 9, B is 28 and C is 35. Semi perimeter 36 cm, sum of three sides divided by 2. So S will be 36. So we'll find area of one triangular tile using Heron's formula. 36 is S, S minus A is 9. 36 minus B is 28, 36 minus 35, C is 35. So after solving it, we'll get 6 into 6 into 27 into 8, making factors of 27, 3 into 3 into 3, and 8, 2 into 2 into 2. So after finding out square root, we'll get the area of one tile as 36√6 cm². So this is area of one tile, but we have 16 tiles, so area of 16 tiles will be 36 into 16. Into √6 cm², so it comes out to be 576√6 cm². Now cost of polishing for 1 cm² is given 50 paisa, and we know 50 paisa is equal to 50/100 rupee. And what is the cost of the required area? Required area was 576√6. So what is the cost of polishing 576√6 cm² 50/100 into the area given, the area what we have find. So after cancelling out, we'll get 288√6 rupees. Now you can see this is 288√6, and we know root 6 is 2.449, or we can write 2.45 approximately. So put the value of root 6, because we have to find the cost and we cannot keep the cost in root form, so we have to find the value of root 6 first. So I have find already, this is approximately 2.45. After putting the value of root 6, we'll get a cost as 705 rupees 60 paisa. So this is the cost of polishing the 16 tiles or the design, floral design, which are in the shape of triangular tiles. The cost is 705 rupees 60 paisa. So this completes your exercise 12.2. Question 9 again is not in your syllabus. Question 1 2 3 5 and 9 are not in syllabus. 1, 2, 3, 5, and 9 are not, we are not doing these 5 sums. So rest I have done. So I hope you are clear with all the sums. Thank you so much.